r/AskReddit. What's the weirdest thing that you've seen at someone's house that they thought was completely normal? Once when I was a kid, I was invited to stay over for dinner at a friend's house. My friend's mother poured a large quantity of ketchup into a cereal bowl, which the entire family all casually dipped their fingers into and licked throughout the meal. That sounds like something out of the Twilight Zone. I find this deeply disturbing. Maybe they didn't want you to ever come back over. This was when I was a kid. I was at my friend's house, and her mom got us some orange juice with our lunch. When we finished eating, she took the remaining juice from the cups and poured it back into the container. Even as a kid, I thought it was disgusting. The last glass of juice in that container would probably be mostly backwash. Just awful. Why is there pulp in this? No pulp, OJ. Oh no. This is me reposting from the last time this question came up, but I feel like these people deserve the double shame. They keep a sewing needle pin stuck into their hand towel. I found it by reaching to use the hand towel to dry my hands and putting the pin through my finger. I was like, WTF guys, and they just shrugged us in. You don't have sharp objects hiding in towels? They then went on to explain that it was used for draining pimples. This is how you get hepatitis. I would have been less upset if it was just a trap. Kid in the home going to the fridge, grabbing a stick of butter, unwrapping it, taking a big bite, rewrapping and putting it back. When my brother and I were kids, we would often comment that our next door neighbor's house smelled like pee. One day my brother was playing video games with a kid from next door at his house and asked to use the restroom. The kid said, "We just pee here," and started peeing in the closet. My brother peed in there too. When in Rome, we pee in the closet and use the bathroom as a breakfast nook. I met this kid in third grade and he seemed normal. Cool kid. Funny. Anyway, I go to his house to work on a school project and his mother was a hoarder. Worst of the worst. She could have a marathon of the hoarders in her own home. I guess the kid thought it was normal because he had been living in it since he was born. He was kinda disheartened when he came to my house and didn't have to climb over mounds of trash to take a piss. A good high school friend's mom was a hoarder. We had to navigate narrow corridors through all the piled junk to get to his room. His tidy, Spartan, immaculately clean room. Many of us do our best not to become our parents. You can learn from everything. Even if it is just learning how not to live. / I had a friend like that too. This would have been in 8th grade for me. Both parents were well-respected teachers at the local school. There was no reason, really, to suspect they were any different than the rest of us. Hell, one day I went to his house to hang out, and there were piles and piles of stuff everywhere, like 2-3 feet of paper and mail on the counters, pots and pans stacked up to your waist, mounds and mounds of stuff on every possible surface. We ate lunch and I just kind of held my bowl on my lap. One time we spent 15 minutes looking for the phone. There were paths around the house where you could walk, barely, without hitting your elbows on stuff. We never talked about it. We always hung out in the basement, where his bedroom was. From down there you'd have no idea how much of a mess the upstairs was. He was a pretty normal kid. I guess it was hoarding. But at the time I didn't have a word for it. We just conveniently never addressed it. To this day I still think about it and how downright bizarre it was. I went to a friend's house and they had their halls lined with grandfather clocks. This was a little weird but nothing major. The weird part came when his dad told me and my friend, "Don't you kids go around telling anybody about my clocks. Now he'll never forget about his precious clocks." My neighbor was super into grandfather clocks. Turns out his collection was worth hundreds of thousands of dollars, and that was the reason he didn't want anyone to know. When he passed, many went to a museum. Did a couple of tours in Iraq and went in hundreds of houses. Common thing was if they had a DVD player or some other kind of electronic device, they would always keep the styrofoam packing on the device. I don't know if they thought it was part of the DVD player or if it prevent dust from entering. Also saw a great number of what I call barn people. Pretty much kids that are too dysfunctional and mentally challenged to live with the rest of the family. So they keep them in the barn or shed. Pretty sad. Most likely that they were trying to keep it in good condition. Stuff like that is fairly common in parts of the world where things like DVD players are a big deal. I thought you were talking about barn people until I got to the end of that sentence. my ex-wife's 90-year-old grandmother had three special vases that were her prized possessions. She would show them to everyone when they came over. They were bongs, stems and bowls still on the side. No one ever had the heart to tell her. Flowers are flowers, I suppose. I guess you could call them potted plants. Went to a party in college and the kid living there had boxes of Cat Fancy magazine catalogued by month and year all over his room. When I asked about it, the dude just shrugged and said, "I'm into cats." I was too nervous to ask more. How many years ago was that? Before people started sharing cat pictures on the internet, maybe? Many years ago. He may have had an Angelfire or tripod page. Had a friend in high school. Went to his house for the first time and everything smelled like piss. Turns out he had a dog and his family never bothered to potty train or clean up after it. Everything in the house was covered in old dried up urine and fresh puddles. While I was there, the dog peed on my friend's bed and he didn't even care. He literally sleeps in his dog's piss. Even I got pissed on. Never went to his house again. There are so many replies like this. Why is this such a common thing? Maybe everyone just knows the same family. Not me, but when my dad was younger he went to a friend's house who had a hallway with nude family pictures. A couple I know have some rather amorous shots of themselves up in the living room. They are into photography, so there are a lot of normal pictures of travel and animals, and then a few where he is obviously plowing her good. I know a guy whose entire home has a layer of dog and cat hair on everything. He told me, if I vacuum the hair, there's gonna be hair on everything in like 30 minutes. So I just don't vacuum it. My eyes just watered from reading this. Ugh. I wouldn't go walking around barefoot there. Just imagining the hair getting all stuck between your toes. Shudder. Hey, had a room that was off limits touch. It was made up like a living room but you weren't allowed there. I'm not sure if that's too unusual. There were two sitting rooms in my house growing up that were essentially adults only. I think parents just don't want kids messing up the nicer rooms. I had a room like this in my house growing up. It was a formal living room. It was so clean, there were always perfect vacuum tracks in the carpet. A friend of mine always took pride in leaping as far into the room as he could to create a single mystery footprint in the carpet. The carpet, unfazed, just swallowed up the footprint into more vacuum tracks like magic. I had a friend in high school whose family used a G.I. Joe aircraft carrier as a coffee table. I had one of those as a kid. It was huge, so my dad rigged a setup where it hung from the ceiling and would get it down for us to play with. One time after school my friend and I tried to get it down with a broom and one side came unhooked. Knocked my poor friend out cold. He wasn't allowed over after that. A 5-year-old in diapers. I was an adult literacy volunteer and I went to this couple's trailer. A kid walks in shirtless, wearing a diaper. At first, I thought it was a joke. Then I thought maybe developmental issues. Then the mother says, "About time to change a diaper, ain't it?" And the boy said defiantly, "You ain't gonna change my diaper. Hey baby, quit selling weed, man. You got your whole life ahead of you." We had a human skull in a glass case in our living room growing up. It was years before I figured out that was really weird. My mom got it from a doctor friend or something. Just some random head. Not like a relative or anything. We called him Freddy and had to superglue his jaw back on every few years when it fell off. I guess I had repressed the memories, but just typing this now I recall touching it and playfully tossing it around gently at times. I'm torn between wanting to respect the dead and really wanting a skull. A jug of piss by their bed because they were too lazy to walk to the bathroom. It's the way of the road, bubs. When I moved cities in grade 2 or 3 I didn't know anyone. I met someone the first day and he invited me to his house that weekend to stay over. Everything was great. We played GameCube and stayed up until 3 a.m. The latest I had been awake up to that point. He said we had to sleep in the basement so that we don't wake his parents when we went upstairs. We'd go downstairs with our sleeping bags and immediately I knew something was wrong. The worst smell I've ever experienced filled my nostrils the further we descended. In the corner of the room was a bed covered in what looked like crusty blood and some pus-colored streaks. Turns out his mother had a home birth the week before and kept the sheets as a memento. I haven't been back since. You'd think that the baby would be a good enough memento. When I was dating my first girlfriend in high school, I was invited over to her house for dinner and meet the parents, etc. At one point I was talking with her father in his study and noticed lots of old looking phallic objects on the shelves in the room. On closer inspection, they were mummified penises. Dozens of them. Turns out he was a urologist and an amateur archaeologist. My friend's dad. When I was a kid I used to stay for dinner as kids do, but the dad would not eat with us. The mom would make a plate of food, take it down the hall and slide it halfway under the door to the basement. A few seconds later the plate would slowly slide under the door. Nobody at the house seemed to think this was odd, but I thought it was weird as duck. The other odd thing this family did was every weeknight at 7 o'clock on the dot, the family would clear out of the living room so the dad could come and watch Star Trek. Once the show was over, he would go back into the basement and the family would move back into the living room. Ducking what? The father was quiet but seemed to be normal other than those odd habits. The family thought none of that was weird and my friend thought it was funny my dad ate with us at dinner. When I was in college I played the drums in a band and we would often practice at the guitar player's house because his parents didn't care about the noise. The family was weird and the house smelled. But the thing that got me was the filth. There was always dog shit somewhere and I don't think they ever flushed or cleaned a toilet. All of this was considered normal to them. Then one day the guy that played guitar walked over to the corner of the room and pissed on the floor. I was stunned. He wasn't drunk or anything like that. This was normal to him. His parents didn't care either. It was just how they did things. I will never forget as a child visiting my friend's house and noticing the wallpaper they had in his hallways. The pattern was of naked women. Throughout his apartment, just little naked women all over the wall. We were maybe 8 years old, and it was amazing. When I was 8 years old my friend told me she had Super Mario, so of course we went to her house. Her parents thought it was okay to let her mentally handicapped older brother, probably around 15, wander around the house naked with a gigantic erection casually masturbating from room to room. The room with the Nintendo was just a mattress, no sheets, and the TV. So at one point he went into the other room and grabbed a chair, set it right down next to the TV facing us and went to town. Her mother walked into the room and let us know it was time for dinner. Food stamp breakfast cereal. And the kid barely touched his food, just constant jerking off while they all ignored it like it was no big deal. The masturbating is common among mentally handicapped people. One summer I worked at a camp for severely autistic children and during dinner we discovered one of the campers, a girl about 15 years old and overweight, had the ketchup bottle from the table in her kitten and was riding it during dinner. The counselors discovered what she was doing and put the ketchup back on the table. Nobody said anything. I lost 14 pounds in 4 days from not eating. I went to high school with a girl whose family would dress up their house like a model home being sold or something. For example, the dining room table was dressed with a plastic Thanksgiving feast, with plastic food on nice plates and fake wine in fake glasses. When you walked into her bedroom the bed was made with top corner open as if she just got out of bed and there was a tray with a fake bowl of cereal and a fake glass of orange juice. On the floor were coloring books and crayons as if a child lived in the room. They kept the place spotless and every room had an odd theme of fake living. Her parents' bedroom had quite a few large African animal statues and fake rose petals leading to the bed. People actually get paid to live in model homes for sale. They have to keep them immaculately clean and ready to be shown at any time. Bathroom machete. Because, you know, just in case. Man, it's literally nothing more than a real machete that hangs in their bathroom. So if someone breaks in while you're fighting dirt dragons, you aren't at a total disadvantage. Everyone there was surprised when I said I'd never heard of it. I now keep a bathroom hammer handy, because goddammit, it's a great idea. I had a friend named David and he invited me to his house once. Little did I know that his family were horrific hoarders. You couldn't see the floor of his house, and I was literally stepping in bowls filled with cereal. At one point, I saw a snake just slither through the refuse and immediately made up an excuse that I was sick so I could go home. What a nightmare. A 6-year-old boy carrying around a framed picture of Vanna White, kissing it and hugging it. He supposedly took it everywhere and slept with it too. We were getting something out of his dad's closet when I noticed there was a ton of expensive electrical equipment in the back of it, all still boxed up. I asked him about it. Apparently his dad keeps everything new he gets for a year before he unboxes it and actually uses it. He didn't know why, and it still boggles my mind. Or his dad stole electronics and held onto them before fencing them or using them. That would certainly be less strange though. Quick story. I grew up in an Irish Catholic family. My parents were constantly fighting. As soon as you would set foot inside our home, the tension would just wrap itself around you and squeeze you. One wrong move and all that tension would just explode. So for my brothers and sisters and me, we would do our best to avoid that basic family interaction so you weren't the one who would potentially cause the next tension explosion. Fast forward many years, so I was set to meet my now ex-girlfriend's family. Great people, kind of your typical Midwestern parents, extremely nice and amazing people. So anyways, I meet them and everything is great. Her mother makes an amazing dinner and we feasted. Afterwards we sat down upon the couch and we all just talked. No TV, no cell phones, no bickering, no fighting, no talking shatty about other family members. Even her nephews sat on the floor and listened to the stories being told by everyone. And then it hit me, that whole scene of us just sitting there with all systems normal. That moment was so strange to me, but it was really a life-changing event for me. To know that families like that do exist, a weird experience for me, a great experience. My ex-boss had put post-its all over her refrigerator nagging her husband about personal hygiene stuff. Jim, I need you to brush your teeth for one full minute today, and floss. Embarrassing, right? Even if he had bad hygiene, which as far as I could tell, he didn't. Is that how you go about it? Shaming him in front of friends and family? This woman was also batshit cra-cra at work. Just a terror. Incompetent high school type bully that really got off on seeing other people suffer. One day, he's gonna hang his wild years on a nail that he drove through her forehead. Just saying. I'd put money on it. Whoa, you made it to the end? You're a ducking beast. I'll cuss you a deal. Smash like and subscribe for more curated content, bruh. It's free and that's a great price.